Rachel Ramsey. I'm here at IT Expo in Miami. I'm here with Greg Tirico, the Senior Social Media Manager of Sage. Hi. Nice to have you, Greg.
Good to meet you, Rachel.
So just tell me a little bit about your company.
Sure. So Sage makes business management software for small and medium-sized businesses. We have about 6 million customers around the globe, accounting software, CRM software, ERP software.
Okay, great. And as social media manager, tell me, what is the company's approach to social media and the customer experience?
Good question. So what I find is that the brand promise and a customer's experience, particularly in the social space, need to be very closely aligned. Right? If your brand is making promises that your company can't necessarily support, then you're going to have a significant disconnect. Mm-hmm. So at Sage, fortunately for me, it's made my job, I believe, a lot easier. We have an embedded belief in the idea of what internally we refer to as an extraordinary customer experience. And that simply manifests itself in the social media space. No problem too big, no problem too small. If you're a customer, we're there for you and we want to find you the help that you need. And that really, as sort of a guiding light, drives all of our social media activities.
Okay, great. Is there any particular ways that you have used social media? There's a lot of outlets, Facebook, Twitter, Google+. Is there anything in particular you guys have done recently?
So recently, one thing that I found was it was fun, it was fairly innovative, and it got us some reasonable press. We conducted a Google+ Hangout and YouTube live streaming event with an individual by the name of Gene Marks. And Gene is a columnist for Forbes, amongst many other publications. He ended up writing a column about his experience with Sage during this live streaming event, but not about necessarily the subject matter, about the experience in using the technology. And he felt, I agree with him, he felt that the idea of a traditional webinar could potentially shift towards a live streaming event based on our experience with Google+ Hangouts. And the great thing about Google+ Hangouts and the associated YouTube live streaming events is that YouTube in and of itself is going to net you a lot of exposure anyway. And so for those video moments, we found it to be a pretty successful and very efficient tool.
Okay, great. And what about events? How do you utilize social media and hosting events?
Yeah, so that's a big topic. We do have one large event a year called Sage Summit. It's our partner and customer conference. It has roughly 4,000 attendees. And what we set out to do a few years ago was bring some focus to the idea of the social media conversation that was already occurring at the event anyway. Physically, it manifests itself in the event in the way of our social media lounge. So we have a section of the event where individuals can go and on large screens watch our social media activity. They can congregate. It's a meeting point for them. But above and beyond that, we found that a lot of our attendees, not a lot, but a significant portion of our attendees were maybe a little less than comfortable with the idea of Twitter as a real-time communications tool at the event itself. So last year, and we'll continue on through further events, we started conducting Twitter 101 and Twitter 201 sessions to get the general attendee population up to a more appropriate common level in terms of using Twitter as a real-time conversational tool. And we've done that with massive success. It's been a great program, and we have a lot of fun doing it.
Great. Well, that's really exciting. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
You're welcome.